Hi guys, welcome to this speed build video in The Sims 4. My name is Irene and today I am building the Norse mythical city of Asgard with the World Tree, aka the Yggdrasil, the Bifrost, the Rainbow Bridge over which you can travel to different realms, a massive spring, a palace, living quarters, a marketplace where you can buy swords or magic familiars and way, way more. It's been a while since I've been uploading and I'm so excited to be back. I'm so happy to be uploading again. Last video was 4 weeks ago. My idea was to come back in 2 weeks, but this build took me 2 weeks to build and to edit, so that's why it took so long. My initial reason to take a break, you know, COVID lockdown in the Netherlands. We are in a hard lockdown right now with a curfew at night and only one visitor a day. And there were a lot of angry people, a lot of riots in my country. And last year I didn't have that mindset around lockdown, that negative thing at all. But this time around, I just couldn't cope that well. I didn't know what happened with it, but I just needed a break. But I am so happy to be back. I feel refreshed. I have so many cool new ideas for this channel and for builds. So yeah, I'm very happy to be back. And I'm so happy to be talking to you guys as well. How you've been? I totally missed the release of the new stuff pack, the paranormal stuff pack. And in this build, I incorporated some items from that new pack as well. But yes, Asgard, maybe you know it from the Marvel movies, you know, where Thor lives. You could see it very well in different Marvel movies, but in the latest one with Thor Ragnarok as well. One of my favorite Marvel movies, but to be honest, you can wake me up in the middle of the night for a Chris Hemsworth movie. But maybe you know it from these movies. Maybe you just know it from the Norse myths and it just speaks to the imagination. How did I came to this idea to build this today? Well, in the break that I took, I just crawled into my safe place, my happy place, and I played games, a lot of games. That's the thing that I love to do. And normally, of course, I'm always recording and building and editing, and now I really had the time to play some other games. I played Minecraft. Oh my god, what a game. More about that later on. But I also played Assassin's Creed Valhalla. A couple of years ago, Assassin's Creed totally mixed up their formats. The first new game with the new formats, the new formula was Origins. Not the old school typical Assassin's Creed feel, but more open world RPG, massive game. First one, Origin, took place in Egypt, ancient Egypt. I liked that. Okay, but the second one, Odyssey, in the all around Greek mythology. I loved that one so much. It was my favorite game like last year or something. It came out so amazing and it was massive, and they came with a new game again a couple of months ago, I think only 2 months ago, Assassin's Creed Valhalla, and I totally dived into that game. It's a massive open world game, and in this case it all was going about the Norse mythology, and you are a Viking called Eivor. You can be a girl, you can be a guy if you want, and I like that a lot because I want to be totally immersed into my game. I want to have that immersive experience, and I love it when I can be a girl in a game. And it was such a massive game. I'm 120 hours in and still not near finishing. But it's all around Norse mythology and Vikings, and at a certain moment you can travel to Asgard as well. And normally I would show you a picture on screen right now from Asgard, the interpretation of Asgard in that Assassin's Creed game. But it was one of these moments in the game. Like, I don't want to spoil it. I was totally amazed how it looks. So that's why I don't want to place a picture of Asgard to spoil things in the game. On your screen right now, I had the same experience with Fallout 3. The first time I played Fallout 3, and the first time I came out of the vault and the bright lights when you see the wasteland for the first time, and was totally amazed with that wasteland as well then, and I had the same experience with Asgard in Assassin's Creed Valhalla. But long story short, this build is based on Assassin's Creed Valhalla, or yeah, the Asgard in Assassin's Creed Valhalla. It is totally different though. It is totally different. The layout is different. The look is different, but it sparked my imagination seeing Asgard in that game. In the beginning, I told you guys that maybe you know Asgard from Thor Ragnarok or other Thor movies in the Marvel movies, And that Asgard in these movies, it looks totally different. And I will show you a picture of it right now. You see, it's way more with spikes and with spires. And yes, it just looks totally different than what I'm doing here right now. So in that way, it is based on that Asgard from Assassin's Creed Valhalla. The Asgard in a Marvel, in the Marvel movies, is, yeah, looks way more like metal. Little bit more futuristic, and I love that look a lot as well, but for this time around I wanted to go for that particular style. You could see it in the cinematic intro. It's kind of the same style that you could see in my Sunken City of Atlantis video as well, from not my last upload but the one before that. Thank you so much for the amazing response on that video though. But yeah, it was kind of the same, yes, similar style. And of course, I use my own imagination and my own fantasy. A lot of things that I had to make smaller on one lot for this build. Normally, in the stories, I dived into Norse mythology and all about Asgard, and I'm sure I'm slaughtering the names. So I'm sorry for my pronunciation. But what I wanted to say, yes, I had a couple of things. I written that down on a list that I wanted to incorporate in this build. First of all, the Rainbow Bridge. And you can see it on your screen already here right now. It looks very different at the moment. It will totally change up later on. I wanted to make the Bifrost. The Bifrost is basically the bridge, the rainbow bridge, and over the bridge you can travel, and you can travel to different realms. That one fitted on the lot. Yeah, that was what I'm talking about. I had to minimize a lot of things because in Asgard there are basically 9 palaces, and of course I couldn't fit that all on this particular lot. So I made everything a little bit smaller, but I had a couple of things that I really wanted to incorporate. That was what I was saying. And like that Bifrost, that Rainbow Bridge, now I used glowing floor tiles. They came with the Spider pack. I wanted to go for these rainbow colors, but I wanted to... Yeah, it looks... Of course, it doesn't look real. It is a fantasy build, but it looks very, very cartoony at the moment. And later on, I will combine it with these massive, yeah, lights, glowing orbs. I used one already, but I will use more. And in that way, it looks more like it's lit up, not just these colors. Your sim can still walk over it. At the end of the Rainbow Bridge, I will place a realm of magic, a portal, so you can really travel to different realms. I thought it was cool. But a Bifrost in the Marvel movies, and I watched these movies so many times, so I still had it in the back of my mind. It was really a very big sword in the middle of an orb, and that turns around, all that stuff, so I wanted to use that a little bit in this build as well. So that's why I placed it. Massive sword over there in that round orb. That round orb I made with a lot of items, yeah, just the same item, but I copied it a lot in all different angles to create that circle shape. It was an item that came with the Perfect Patio pack. And that sword that I used, it's a short sword in the game, but it's normally not in this position, so I rotated it with the tool mod. But that was one of the first things that I really wanted to incorporate in this build. I wanted to have the Yggdrasil as well, the World Tree. And the Yggdrasil has its roots in Helheim, the place where Hell is. It has his middle part in Midgard. Midgard is basically our world where we live. And it has his leaves and his branches in Asgard in the Norse mythology. And I wanted to do something with that as well. I wanted to place a massive tree in. You can see that later on, of course. I wanted to make a palace with a throne room. I wanted to make it a little bit more, kind of on the edge of elvish, that palace part, the exterior of the palace part. But the interior will be full on Viking, and the part below the palace, that is more for, the poor district. Yeah, it sounds a little bit strange, but the living quarters, they're still very nice to live in. I will make a marketplace over there, and in Norse mythology there are three, if I'm correct, massive wells or springs in Asgard as well. So I will place one in this build too. With the entire shape already finished, you can see it right here. I took the approach that I wanted to make the initial shape first, then the landscaping, and after that I wanted to focus on all the decorations of the buildings. Talking about the landscaping, I just placed that tree in that could go as Yggdrasil, in my opinion. It is that magic tree. You can just find it amongst your base game items. And I think it's a debug item though, but it's that magic tree. When you interact with it a couple of times, you can travel to that, that magic or secret world. I think it's something called like the Sylvan Glade or Silver Glade. I'm not totally sure, but you have to water it, all that stuff. And I thought this one was particular cool for a particular reason, very cool, because it has that kind of curved shape, so I could make the entire city just scattered all around it. I could really size this one up. With sizing up items in the game, you always have the chance that it doesn't look that good. Especially with older items, and this one came with the base game, so it's the oldest one in the game. With older items, I experience sometimes that when I size up an item, it can look very, very chunky, or the game will glitch out. But in this particular time, I could really size this tree up, and the cool thing is that it lights up during the night. Yay! So pretty and a little bit magical, so I thought it was very fitting. I placed in extra roots to really make it look like this entire city was built against Yggdrasil. The roots that I used here, they came with the Vampires pack, and they are a debug item, and I love using them! Oh man, I love using them so much. I used them in, I think, the last four builds that I did. And they almost had the same color as the tree that I was using. I sized them up a lot and I placed them around the entire build, and in that way I created that effect here. I've already started on the decoration of the palace, all the different walls. I wanted to place in a lot of accents everywhere. I just did it in certain steps. I knew how I wanted to do these arches over here, and I wanted to do some kind of bridges. So I just took this step by step, what I already knew how I wanted to do it. So that was the whole process here. So that's why I'm switching between buildings a couple of times. But basically, the upper one, the palace, will be a little bit more white in the exterior. And in the interior, not at all though. And the lower part will be more with darker stone and with a lot of fires everywhere. I will place fires in later on where you can grill food over, cook food over. And I will place a bigger fire in to kind of go as an anvil or a blacksmith thing. But the entire shape of the build right now, without all the decorations and without all the things on the exterior, it kind of reminded me, just the shape and the height, a little bit, just a little bit, of Minas Tirith, the amazing city in the Lord of the Rings. The last build I did was a magic book, and in that magic book, I made a massive book, and in that magic book, I made a Lord of the Rings world, so I made a smaller hobbit house, I made the Tower of Sauron and Mount Doom and all that stuff. If you haven't seen that video already, I will put the link on your screen. But under that video, I got a lot of requests to do Minas Tirith one day, and oh man, that would be so amazing! And when I read it, I thought that wouldn't be possible at all, ever. But after I've done this one, I think it's possible. I think I can do that. So I think that will happen in the future. I really want to try even more bigger builds like that in the future. I've been doing a lot of bigger builds with my previous videos as well, but I wanted to take a little bit of a different approach after this break. I really feel refreshed and I feel inspired and I want to do so many things, but I felt a little bit smothered in the schedule that I made for myself. So it was all my own fault that I made me feel like that. But a new approach for my builds is, like with this one, I want to make cool builds and not just for the sake of uploading and keeping on my schedule. I want to place quality over quantity. So I want to do, I think, even bigger builds like that, and I really want to take my time with them. So in the future, it may be possible that sometimes you have to wait a little bit longer for a video. I will be working very hard on it though. Every day I won't be playing another game like Assassin's Creed for 120 hours or something like that. I will be spending a lot of time on it, so it won't be 4 weeks or something, but I want to take my time with the builds and I want to upload them when I finish them and when I'm done with editing, and not put pressure on myself with these ridiculous schedules that I have. So sometimes you have to wait a little bit longer for a video. But when I'm going to do maybe a smaller build, they could be epic as well, I think so even. But when I'm doing a smaller build, it could be the case that I'm ready in like 3 days or 2 days. So there will be even more videos in that week than just 2 a week. So I want to focus on the process, I want to focus on the quality and not that much on the quantity or on my upload schedule. I'm totally going to ditch that schedule. So now you know, when you have to wait a little bit longer on a video, I'm really working on something different. And I want to spend a little bit more time on editing. I want to experiment with that a little bit more, and I want to take my videos to the next level with editing as well. In this particular one, I experienced a little bit with transitions between day and night in my intros. Maybe you've noticed that already in the intro, and I want to experience with that more. I want to practice with that a little bit more. So yeah, I really want to take my videos to the next level. So sometimes you have to wait a little bit longer. I hope you guys don't mind. And just a couple of sentences ago, I said I'm going to work very hard on it and not going to spend time, a lot of time, in other games. Well, that wasn't totally true. Because, yes, I've started playing Minecraft. And I played Minecraft like 2 years ago for a couple of weeks. I didn't know what I was doing at all. So it didn't work out at all. But I started like 4 weeks ago again, just a week or two, and yeah, it wasn't totally clear to me yet. But then I started watching a live stream from someone who has over 3,000 days in hardcore mode in Minecraft. So when he dies, he loses his world. He's from the Netherlands as well, just as me. His name is Looney, and man, I loved it so much and I got so inspired by that. So I've started something new, yes. Don't worry, this is not going to be a Minecraft channel at all. But I started a new world, and not in hardcore mode though, in survival mode. And when I want to relax a little bit, I'm going to play Minecraft just a couple of times a week. And I've started on a new world, and I have big plans for that world. My plan is to find strongholds. These are underground. I want to dig it out. A massive circle, massive gap in the ground. I want to dig as far as I can. Then I'm going to build a massive, even bigger, tree in the middle of it. With a stronghold half in it as well. And I have so many more plans for it. And my idea, I think that's going to take me months, maybe years. And my idea was to make, like, maybe once a year, maybe once every 6 months, a kind of an update video, how my world in Minecraft is going. Because I have so many big plans for massive builds in Minecraft as well. Like I said, I don't want to be a Minecraft channel, totally switch things around, of course not, but I feel I can be so creative in Minecraft as well. So I want to give it a try. I think the first progress video will be almost a year from now, but yeah, I will tell you every once in a while about how progress is going. Maybe I'm going very fast and it's totally not a priority, of course, these builds and these videos and The Sims, my priority, but I think I can totally let my creative imagination run free with Minecraft as well. And there's so many amazing, massive builds out there, and I think I can do that as well. Sounds a little bit strange, but I think I can do that as well. So yeah, that's a new thing that is going to happen. But like I said, it's almost around a year or something when you see the first thing about that. But yeah, very exciting. And that break, it was so good for me. I feel so inspired now. I feel so refreshed now. And I cannot wait to build more and to upload more and to experience different things and to try out different things in the game. I have a little bit of hopes though that in maybe the next year The Sims 5 will be announced, because I want to try out yet different things, and I think a whole new Sims game would be very great for my creativity and my imagination. But of course I can totally get crazy with The Sims 4 as well. While I was talking about totally different things, let me explain you a little bit about things that I did here in, yeah, with this exterior. Like I said, the back part is the palace, that part is already finished. It looks a little bit elfish right now, but trust me, later on the interior will be very Viking. I know Norse gods, because Asgard is the dwelling of the Norse gods, and gods are not the same as Vikings, but that's kind of emerged in my head, Vikings and these Norse gods, so I really went full Viking with it. The back part is a little bit wider, and you could see it just over there. I placed on the side of the palace a very big kind of banner thing. It's a wall decoration with white thread. Well, it's very cool. It's a new item that came with that new stuff pack, and I will use a couple of the new lights with the new stuff pack. And yeah, when I see them, when I notice them while I'm talking, I will point out what are the new items with that particular pack. I didn't use them although, but I think it's amazing that we have like a kind of new fortune teller orb thing right now, and these wall decorations, some very cool new plants, but I didn't feel the need to make a paranormal special build or something like that. Yeah, maybe I'm going to do a haunted house, but a totally over the top massive haunted house later on in the future. But I wanted, when I'm going to do a haunted house like that, I want to make it really like a haunted house. That you can visit it with your sim and you have to solve puzzles in different rooms. I know that it's possible in the game, but I'm not totally sure how to do it. And before I know that, I didn't want to start on a build like that, but I have used some of these paranormal items in the build. I just made this, and I'm working on it still. It is a spring or a well. In Asgard, in the stories, there are three of these wells, and in Assassin's Creed Valhalla, you will dive in one of these wells as well. And I had so many water here, and I already placed a lot of these fountains in to create a look of waterfalls everywhere. And I thought it would be cool to have, this well in the middle of this water as well. I think it just looks a little bit more interesting than just flat water. Unfortunately, you cannot dive in that pool, or you cannot dive in that well. That really would be amazing. We're onto the interior right now, and over here, this is the very bottom part of the entire build, and this is a kind of the living quarters. It isn't that fancy over here, but I still wanted to make it look pretty though, because yes, it is an Asgard, and I couldn't get away with something that didn't look pretty. And I had this particular item, you can see it right here on the wall, the skull. I think in game it's something called as a Minotaur skull or a dinosaur skull. I'm not totally sure, but you can see them on the flags that I placed on the wall as well. These flags with these, they look a little bit like bulls, with these bull skulls and that wall decoration with the skull on it as well. They came with the Star Wars Journey to Batuu pack, and I used them a lot throughout this entire build. Especially that skull, not the one on the flag. I think it looks so amazing. And I had to size it up a lot and to really get that effect. But I think it really gave this build more like a Viking effect and not just like this palace thing. Over here is a bigger bedroom. It's kind of like, a place to live in. I wanted to make a very small kitchen over here to make it functional. And on the other side will be a smaller bathroom. In the palace, in the upper palace, will be a very luxurious bedroom as well. Fit for a Norse god, fit for Thor. And there will be a bathtub and a toilet as well. According to eating and cooking over here, I wanted to make this build functional for your sims, so you really can experience some kind of Norse adventure. I thought it would be fun. I wanted to place this kitchen in, but when you're pulling this build from the gallery, if you want, of course, and when you're using this one in your build, I recommend to cook your food over an open fire. I'm sorry. Recommend you to cook it over an open fire, because I will place one level higher some fires as well. You can roast different things over that open fire. And for the entire Viking feel, I think that is a little bit more fitting to just cook your food there. But if you want, you can cook your food there, and maybe you can make massive feasts or massive meals and go a little bit with that around that Viking or Norse game play. Same for the bathroom. I just wanted to place it in because I wanted to make this build functional. You have to use the teleportation cheat though to enter this build, but after that everything is functional. I didn't want to destroy the look of the water all around it with a pathway or with letters or something. And teleportation is so easy in the game. And I thought, when you're playing around with a build like this, when you're choosing to go to play this as a female version of Thor or something, that's the sim that I created that you can see popping up in the left corner of your screen every once in a while. We already went that far to go for that kind of gameplay. I think you can teleport over here as well. It's very easy for the people who don't know how to teleport in the game. You have to enable the cheats. Ctrl-Shift-C on your keyboard, that will enable the cheat box. Type in over there, testing cheats true, the space between it. After that, just click enter, Ctrl-Shift-C again, so the cheat box isn't there in your screen anymore. After that, hold shift, click somewhere in your world where you want to be, click on teleport sim, and it takes a second and your sim is there. It is so easy to use. Over here is a very small marketplace, and although this build looks massive, it is very massive, the interior isn't that massive, but I wanted to really use every single inch of this interior. So I made these two market stalls over here. You can really place a sim there. Your sim can really interact with it. You can barter over there. You can hassle with other sims. You can really buy stuff there with your sim. The things that I placed on the tables, that's what you can sell. But of course, you can place more over there if you want. We're already onto the palace, but when you took a look at the front of the marketplace, at the right, you can buy swords and shields. And at the left, you can buy magic books and magic familiars. And like I said, it's very nice, totally different way of playing the game when you play around with these tables. I think the particular one that I used came with El Salvadorado, with a jungle adventure pack, but you have versions with city living and with eco lifestyle as well. And I think it's very cool that you can barter over there as well. I think that was very fitting for this entire thing I wanted to go for. Here we are in the throne room, and I used this massive throne. It was so fitting. I had to use it here. It came with the Get Famous pack. The Get Famous pack comes with some amazing movie props, and the throne is one of them. And here will be the bedroom, fit for someone like Thor or Odin or Freya or your sim if you want to play around with this build. And then we're almost at the end of this video already. It feels so good to be back. I really miss you guys. I'm very curious how you're doing. Please let me know. I, of course, will be back soon with a new build. I have so many ideas. We're almost just a couple of seconds. Yeah, here we are. We're into the outro right now. It is a massive build, so I made it very long. If you're still here, I'm so happy that you're still here. Yes, I think this is one of the longest videos yet on my channel. But yeah, I'm very happy to be back, and I cannot wait to talk to you during my next video. Have an amazing day. Goodbye.